Guys, we are here. Hey, sorry about that. We've had some internet problems and got bumped off internet, which is just a great way to start our Wednesday service. But hey, we nevertheless are back and we are on. So let's try this one more time. So we had to switch devices, switch a few things, and we are sorry for any interruptions that way, but we are making things work as we go. And we are just going to make this happen tonight. This is what bounce back kind of faith looks like. This is what it means to bounce back and to keep on going.
Yeah, sorry about that, guys. I don't know what happened, but I don't even know where I was at. But nevertheless, God is wanting us to, you know.
Let's do this. You were talking about the faith of God being redemptive, not punitive.
Right.
And you were talking about God's purpose, and we were talking about Peter, I think, is where we were started. We were headed into a conversation mm-hmm. about Peter, and I believe it's Luke chapter 22.
Simon, he said, Simon, Satan has desired to sift thee like wheat, but I've prayed for thee that your faith fail you not. And honestly, Peter went and he denied the Lord Jesus. We know the whole story. And so God always has a redemptive thing about God is that he always has a rooster, because he went and he said, oh, I'm going to love you no matter what. But God already knew, Jesus already knew what Peter was going to do. And eventually you see that the rooster began to crow after he had denied Jesus three times as a reminder. But the rooster wasn't there necessarily just to remind him and to accuse and condemn him. The rooster was there to announce the dawning of a new day.
Yes.
That faith would arise, that Peter, you're going to be the one that's going to bounce back and be the main preacher at the day of Pentecost. And you know what? In one of your preachings, 3,000 people are going to come to the Lord. That's the awesome thing about it. And so, you know, I just feel with all my heart, Meredith, that we need a people that are going to have defiant faith, a people that are going to have resilient faith, a people that are going to have a bounce back kind of faith. You know, even Jesus.
Absolutely.
One thing I do know about God is that anything that he approves of, anything that he approves of, he has to prove. And you see that in the life of Jesus. And in fact, in Matthew 4 and in Luke 4, you see it where Jesus is at the water of baptism, and you see where John is baptizing Jesus, and Jesus is being immersed into the waters of baptism, and pretty soon you see the eastern skies open for the first time in 400 years, and God begins to speak right there and says,
absolutely,
this is my beloved son in whom I'm well pleased. So God gives them his identity, gives him and approves of him right there in the middle of all of the people. He comes and approves them. And then the next chapter, chapter 4, he's led into the wilderness by the Holy Spirit. He's led by the Holy Spirit. Not by the devil. He's led by the Holy Spirit to be tempted by the devil.
Yes.
And so you see, whatever God approves of, he has to prove.
Yes, he does.
Oh, my God. This is a bounce back.
We are bouncing back tonight.
Yeah. So anyway, you talk for a little bit about that. I've noticed one thing, that anytime that God is approving of something, he's going to always have to prove it. And God always has a people of faith that is going to be resilient in the time of adversity, in time of trouble, in the time of oppression, in the time of persecution. There's one thing I know, as a people of faith, always multiply.
Always multiply.
So anyway, elaborate a little bit of that, and then we're going to minister to some people.
Let me talk to you this way, because just going back for a second to Peter, when Peter is about ready, Jesus is about ready to go to the cross, and Peter, and he addresses Peter, mm-hmm. but he addresses him as Simon, Simon. He says, Satan has desired you that he may sift you like wheat.
Right.
But he says something. He says, but I have prayed for you that your faith would fail you not.
Right.
Listen, I believe that we're in an hour that's much the same, where there is absolutely the opportunities for our faith to be sifted, for us to be sifted. But Jesus said something. He said, Satan's desired you. But then he says, he says, but I prayed that your faith would fail you not.
Right.
So I think maybe the way to understand this better is that the testing wasn't necessarily of Peter, but the testing was of his faith. Mm-hmm. What he was about ready to go through, Peter was about ready to fail bigger than he had ever failed, which I love Peter because mm-hmm. I feel like mm-hmm. Peter's so relatable. He stuck his foot in his mouth so many times. He made so many mistakes. He right. did so many things that we do, or at least that I do. So it makes me feel better that, man, if he made it, then you and I can make it. So, here's the thing of it. Jesus knew what he was going to go through before Peter ever knew what he was going to go through.
Absolutely.
And he said something. He said, I prayed for you that your faith would fail you not. Mm-hmm. So at the end of it, wherever you are being shaken, whatever is happening in your life, whatever the stuff you're going through, this is what you have to know, mm-hmm. that God is praying for you that your faith would not be shaken, that you wouldn't Absolutely. Give up. And then he says something amazing because he says, after all these things, after you've gone through it and you've been converted, it's amazing because we yeah. teach in the church today, we teach conversion as what happens at salvation, which is part of it. But Peter has walked with Jesus for almost 3.5 years at this point. Mm-hmm. And Jesus looks at him and says, Peter, there's still places in your life that you're not converted. Mm. There's still things in your life. There's still belief systems that have to change.
That's good.
And so it's something, listen, in the midst of today, because part of why we really wanted to start this series and why what we had talked about just in ourselves, because listen, we got a lot of time to talk right now. But part of the realization of some of that is that we have to realize and understand that there are places in your life and my life that still need to be converted. There's still areas that God is wanting to see change. And he tells Peter, he goes, hey man, after you've gone through it and after you've been converted, then go back and strengthen your brethren. So listen, here's the thing as Christians, if you have been strengthened and your life has changed, mm-hmm. then you have to know and understand that it's okay to go, it's okay to help somebody else with where they're struggling.
Absolutely.
And I think that is so relevant in today's world, because if you listen to the news for more than 5-10 minutes, if you scroll through Twitter, if you're looking on Facebook, I mean, you don't get an email without an update on the virus and the stuff mm-hmm. that we're dealing with today. And at some point, there's either you are going to be overwhelmed by the news of today, or you can take back your faith and take back your place and lead with faith, not mm-hmm. with fear. And when you lead with faith, it makes us, it pushes back on the status quo. I'm not saying that we don't need to be careful. I believe we need to be careful. I believe you right. need to wash your hands. Right, I believe right, you right. need to watch out and mind your business and do the things that even
absolutely.
Our government has asked
no,
us
absolutely.
To do. So I'm not even talking about that. But I'm talking about the fear that overwhelms, mm-hmm, the fear mm-hmm. that takes your breath and makes you feel like you're sick when you don't have a single symptom happening, when you have read enough news that you go take your temperature because you're sure you have a fever by the time you're done. That's the thing that God is wanting to get a hold of and change
Absolutely.
And convert in our lives, because at the end of the day, his word is true and his mm-hmm. promises are amen. They're yes and amen. And
right.
there's something about it when you understand it that we have to stand in a place that is so different than what the world around us mm-hmm. is going through, because otherwise then why are we Christians?
Absolutely.
What makes the difference? If we're as scared as everybody else is, then then what's the good in having a Savior and
right.
having a God that loves us and redeems us?
Right, right,
I read this in the Psalms today. I thought this was so good. Psalms 55 verse 22 says it this way in the Passion Translation, but it says, so here's what I've learned. Through it all, leave all of your cares and your anxieties at the feet of the Lord. And the measureless grace, and his measureless grace, one more time, and his measureless grace will strengthen you.
Wow. I like
so
that.
Here it is, my friends. At some point, you have to just lay it down and give it back to God. At some point, we have to engage our faith and say, we are not going to be afraid. We're going to be wise and we're going to be smart, but we're not going to be a fearful people. Mm-hmm. We are going to take back our power. Mm-hmm. We're going to take back what God has Absolutely. For us. There you go, Sabrina. That is the verse I was looking for. You got to leave it and let God, because God is bigger than you and I. And I promise you, God was never and has never been surprised right. by any of this that we're going through.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, we God gave us this life to enjoy, not to endure.
Absolutely.
And so there's times where we have to, survive. I get that. We will survive. I know. but there's times where God is wanting us to be in a position like we are today to thrive. A lot of times is you won't know until you found a hard place. Hard places are not there to annihilate you. Hard places are there to see really what you're made out of.
Yes.
I went down because, we've been putting together puzzles and then we've been putting together and playing games. I went down and got some Mexican dominoes. We're going to play Mexican dominoes tonight. But it's amazing. But I went down there and I saw a ball. And while Meredith, we were down there, I saw these rubber balls. I got a little bouncy ball, It's amazing. And it has the ability to bounce. Only it bounces really well on hard surfaces. And so here, God is wanting us to understand that sometimes, he's wanting us, there's hard places in our lives, but they're orchestrated for us to bounce back. We have to have a bounce back kind of a faith. We refuse to stay down when the enemy keeps us down because I'm a wrestler by nature. So therefore, there's a fight in me. I was raised with seven kids. You fight. That's just what you do. You love and you fight. And so those of you who understand that, I'm a fighter, not a lover, though I love to love, okay? But my thing is, I'll love you, but if you cross me, I'll beat you up, So in the kingdom, it's no different. When Satan tries to come and he's trying to defy and defile, I mean, that's what I love about Joseph. Joseph, come on, was found in pits and dungeons, but yet he bounced back. He was like that rubber ball. He bounced back because he had a resilient faith in the word that God had put within him, and he held on to that word like a rope of hope. Yeah. And that is what some of you are needing. You have to bring to remembrance what God has spoken about you. You're going to thrive and you're not going to just survive. You're going to enjoy this life and not just endure it. It's a season where God has wanted you to be intentional and he's put his desire in you. And what I love about it is when you understand intention and desire, they're inseparable. Yeah. In fact, when intention and desire is the manifestation of love, love has root emotions and it's intention and desire. When those two are present, then your faith works. Why? Because faith works by love. And so when faith works by love, you know that there's intention and desire. And what I love about it is when intention and desire and faith is working, then it gives birth to commitment. And commitment, yes. I wrote down here, so commitment moves mountains. It's yes. It's commitment that impacts the physical world in which you live in. It's commitment. Commitment is only found when your faith is working together with intention and desire, which is love. Love is behind of that. And so I'm trying to help somebody because maybe you find yourself in a deficit. Maybe you find yourself a little oppressed or even depressed. Out of work. You might find, I'm telling you that there is a bounce back anointing because of a faith. As it don't, faith is what comes out your mouth and what you do with your works of your hands. Let it not be a season where oppression or depression or adversity or perplexity gets the best of you. It is a season, I'm here to tell you, where we have to be a bounce back kind of a people. And if anybody here can say amen, you need to just shout amen. And
give
amen
us some hearts. Give us some love. Do something.
That's
let
what
us
I'm
know.
Talking about, because God's wanting. There's some people right now, Meredith, I think we need to start ministering to some people because some of you have felt like you have been at rough sea without an anchor.
Yes.
And there's some of you that are feeling the commotion of the waves beating upon that boat. And in fact, some of that water is coming into your boat and you feel like you're drowning. But I want to prophesy to you, Meredith, and I want to just tell you that Jesus is becoming the anchor of your boat or your situation and even your condition. Yes. You're going to discover in this season that God is wanting you to take note that God is going to be the steadfastness in your instability. There's a resilience and a bounce back of faith that is going to manifest. And you're going to see God come on in the midst of your little things.
Yes.
And you're going to see things. There's going to be some things that are going to shift for the good on your behalf. For you.
Absolutely.
For the good. So you're about ready to see the tide begin to turn. This thing won't last always. But you're going to see things begin to shift and change and transform and reform what God has always intended. There's intention and there is desire. Come on. And that's birthing forth a commitment. And it's your commitment in this hour. Committed to the relationship. Committed to your workplace. Committed to your children. Committed to your spouse. You're going to find that in the middle of commitment, that's what moves mountains. That's what causes the physical impact of things to come to you or flow through you and be distributed. So I don't know, Meredith, minister to somebody somewhere.
That's really good. Hey, I just want to say even to this, that there's some people of you that are tuning in, that are watching even now and going, man, I don't have a job. I'm at home working or I'm just at home and I can't work. And so I want to pray for you first, just as a general people. And I want to speak to you because I believe that in the midst of the season, God is making a way where there are creative and ingenuitive ideas that are coming your way, where God is causing some things to turn around and giving you avenues of finance that you would have never even taken the time to think of before. And so there's some of you that have been on the verge of new businesses and have had embedded ideas. I want to speak to you that this is a season where God begins to awaken those things and where you take advantage of the time and the place that we're at, because the yes of God and the blessing of God, I believe, is on some of those ideas. And you're going to find that there's quick and swift and open doors that come your way that makes things happen. Pastor Sabrina, I see you on there. I just want to take a minute and minister to you. I believe that the prayer and the place that you even put before God before the first of the year, there's some things I believe that you have laid out for the year that you said, God, I really need to see some stuff happen. Pastor Sabrina, I believe that there's something shifting and God has taken note of the things that you have even asked him for. And there are open doors coming your way. There are phone calls and you go, it's not a season where people should be calling me, but there are phone calls coming your way. Wow. And there's some stuff happening. I think even with schooling and education and all of that, that is going to be a blessing and going to be the very desires of your heart, but it's going to happen better and faster than what you even thought. Hey, William, I see you on there. And I just want to say your season of being removed and being uplifted and taken out is over. That the pushback that has been in your spirit, the thing where you have pushed back and said, God, I need to be back. I need to be planted once again. I believe that this is a time that you're going to find out that some doors begin to open, the way becomes clear, and you're going to find an easy and a quick avenue back into where you should be and into the season that you need. And so I'm believing with you that this is your time, your season, and your placement. God's opening doors of employment and all the things that need to be to put you back in the right place.
Yeah, amen. Cheryl Guild and Oxendines, I know they're watching. I felt like this word was, when I saw your guys' names come up, I saw a compass. And I see that the compass was there to navigate through some of the tough times. So some of the times that, you know, I feel like sometimes it gets obscure, it gets foggy. But you guys, in this next season, you're going to begin to see that the compass, if you just trust the compass of God, the Holy Spirit, come on, that is going to tell you and direct you. He's the great guide in this season. And he's going to lead you and guide you into the truth that will only liberate you. It's a season where God is going to lift you high because you have endured the seasons of obscurity and the seasons of unknown, both both of you guys, and you're going to begin to see that God is going to be your God. You're going to begin to see the prayers that you have prayed for the last 7 years are going to begin to manifest in your families, and you're going to begin to see your even your children be raised up for the kingdom for such a time as this. I don't know about you, but God is doing something. In fact, I got a word of knowledge too for some of you that have been having sleepless nights. Some of you haven't been sleeping very good, but he gives his beloved sweet sleep. It's a word of knowledge tonight that God is wanting to make sure that the peace of God, it's one thing to have the peace of God, but I'm telling you that there's something greater than the peace of God. It's having the God of peace. Yes. The God of peace, you automatically get the peace of God when the God of peace is in you. And I prophesy that in this season that the God of peace would be magnified and the peace of God would be your portion. But you're going to begin to see where God is causing his beloved to have sweet, sweet sleep. There's some of you that haven't slept only but 3, 4, 5 hours and you wake up a little sore, your neck is cranked. But I'm telling you, in this season, God is overshadowing you and he's releasing healing right now into your body and he's causing your sleep to be beautiful. There's also some people that have been struggling with headaches lately. It's headaches. Some of them have been migraine, but some just headaches in the front and in the back of your head. And I just saw the hand of the Lord touching you and removing those from you. And Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we just declare, Father, that you in this season are removing migraine headaches and even indigestion. There's people that are struggling even with indigestive. I see God touching esophaguses. There's some of you that are taking medication for that. You're about ready to see the hand of God touch your esophagus and touch your intestines too. It's just your digestive system. People that are having digestive problems, in the name of Jesus, I saw the hand of the Lord touching your esophaguses and touching intestines. In the name of Jesus, be thou healed. There's also, Meredith, I saw some people that have had their head, they've taken some blows to the head and almost some like concussions. But I just saw the Lord beginning. There's somebody here that is watching that is has had some concussions, have blows to the head, whether it is a fall or something hits you. There is something that, but God is right now causing tremendous peace and tranquility to come upon you, and he's removing any of the effects and damages of the blow or the accident that took place. I don't know if it was an accident, a car, I don't know who it is, but just write me right now. Just let me know that's you. But I saw the hand of God touching you. I saw the hands of God touching you, removing the effects of that in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Your turn, tag, boom, go.
I just want to minister to some of you that have just had like reoccurring stomach issues and in that way, like just stomach pain. And I really heard the Lord say, I'm touching. Some of it's come from stress. Some of it's come from the pressure of the last season. Some of it's just the worry. But in the name of Jesus, listen, if that's you, just take your hand, put it on your stomach. And Father, we release healing and believe that which has come to oppress and to affect your people is so being removed off of them. And we speak peace and we speak the very tranquility of God that would come from head to toe and relieve the pains that have been there in Jesus' name.
Yeah, there's people who have been struggling with their high blood pressure too. Blood pressure, but I also saw people that are struggling with some of their blood sugars. Some of your blood sugars have been skyrocketed. I saw the Lord stabilizing that. So I release healing right now by you, by his stripes. May you be healed in this season. May God go. There's no difference or distance. Come on, claim that for whoever or whatever. But in this season, there's no difference or distance in spirit right now. In the name of Jesus, Amen. You're going to begin to see God stabilize and God heal and set free and deliver in this season right now. In the name of Jesus, high blood pressure, we curse you in the name of the Lord. Come on, blood sugars, come on, stabilize in the name of Jesus. And we allow that in the name of the Lord to take place. Yes, in Jesus' mighty name.
And listen, and the obvious, those of you that have been afflicted with respiratory illnesses, I want you, if you would, just put your hand on your chest for a minute, just as a point of contact, because we can't touch you, but there's no distance in the spirit. And I believe, listen, that God is breathing new life into you. And as you inhale, that you're not just breathing in the air around you, but you're breathing in the life and the air of God, and that it heals and it redeems and it soothes the airways and the places. And so, Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, we speak life and we speak healing to everyone who is watching, who has had respiratory illness, whatever it has been, whether you want it, it's a virus or whatever. We thank you that your name is greater than a virus.
Yes.
And Father, we thank you that today, in the name of Jesus, that healing goes forth. Mm-hmm. Airways open up. Just take a deep breath and let the air in. Mm-hmm. And as you exhale, we release every other thing that has come to affect and infect the people of God in Jesus' name.
There's somebody, Meredith, is having ankle problems, ankle pain in the ankles. I want to say it's your right ankle. But I just saw the hand of the Lord touching the ankle, the joints. Yeah. It's just the ankle joints. It's sometimes having a hard time walking or in the morning getting up. I don't know what it is, but you're going to begin to see that as you move that around, just move it around right there. If that's you, just move it around. You're going to find it might even have popped when I said it, but God's about ready to do something in the ankle. Oh yeah. In the joints right now, in the name of Jesus. And I see a creative miracle that is taking place with the knees. Some of you have needed a knee replacement, but you're going to find out the next time you go to the doctor that there is new cartilage in your knee. And you're going to see that God is the God that he's able in the storehouse of his bounty to give you newness of life in the knees area. There's knees that are being restored in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah. There's a bounce back anointing.
Absolutely.
I said there's a no different than the bouncy ball. Come on, that some of you guys have been through some hardships and some hard times, but nevertheless, it is only because you have the ability to bounce back. There's a bounce back anointing. You have been resilient. You guys are standing firm on the foundation that God spoke his word and you believe it and you're trusting it. But ankles, listen, you got already, Ruby Klein said she's got her ankle healed. I believe that in the name of Jesus.
William
said his popped in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. We're believing that in the name of the Lord right now, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' mighty name. Kodabasaha. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
I just want to remind you, for some of you guys that just have come on recently, part of what we're talking about tonight, this is our midweek service. So welcome to Cornerstone Church. In our dining room. But listen, part of what we were talking about is that God has given us a resilient faith, a bounce back kind of faith. And just like this bouncy ball was made to bounce, and it has, when anytime it hits a hard surface, that it has the ability to bounce back up. I need you, listen, to remember that you were made to bounce back. It's not only that this ball has to have something hard to hit in order for it to bounce back, but the very fabric of what it was made of is made for the purpose to recover,
absolutely,
to bounce, to come back up. And so no matter where you find yourself and no matter what situation you find yourself in, you have to know that God made you to bounce back.
Absolutely.
That you have within you the ability to push back, to come back. And so if you have been down, if you have been discouraged,
right,
if you have been depressed, if you have been oppressed, you have to just shake yourself. Some of you guys just need to stand up, grab your phone, walk around your house, stand up in front of your TV, yell like a crazy person. It's just you and your family, and bounce back. Whatever that means, you have to do physically. Listen, we had trouble getting on online. We had all sorts of stuff tonight. But it's funny to me that that happens in a night that we're talking about.
Come on, we got to bounce back.
Bounce back kind of faith. We wanted to just say, forget it. We'll just do this another night. But there's a demand because there's a people
Absolutely.
That need answers and are hungry for the word of God.
Absolutely.
And so we are bouncing back. We're all recovering. We're all coming through this season. And the truth of the matter is you were made to survive hard
Absolutely.
Times. You were made to survive Yep. hard situations.
Kim Travis, I know you're watching. The scales of justice are being tilted in your favor.
Yes.
The season of your frustration comes to a complete utter end. The Lord has heard your cry. The Lord has seen every tear that you have wept in your bedroom at night at times, so frustrated. But the Lord says, today I'm taking every tear that I have ever taken over the last 10 years. It's been frustrating. You felt as though somebody has handcuffed you spiritually. But the Lord says, I'm removing the handcuffs. The scales of justice are coming and they're tilted in your way. You're going to begin to see that I am the redemption that draws nigh to you, and the prayer you prayed 2 weeks ago shall manifest. Watch and see what God does in the next month and two. God says, I will liberate and I will set free and give you the things that you have prayed for and even spoke out. Oh yes, even in that prayer room 2 weeks ago, the Lord says, I will cause things to manifest, for angels are working on your
yes.
behalf to making room for you. For the Lord says, I have put an anointing on the inside of you, and I have called you from the time I called you out of your mother's womb, and I will make room for you in the house of the Lord. For you shall in the house of the Lord begin to flourish. You've tasted it of once, and now the Lord says there's a bounce back anointing that is coming your way. And as you bounce back, you're going to see the goodness of God on your situation. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
There's a bounce back anointing. There's just a bounce back faith. It's a time to be encouraged, everybody. It's a time to be, I can't even fish. They closed down the launches. Can you believe that? I was so
Pray
upset. I was like,
me.
come on.
For me.
But it's okay. It's a time to bounce back. It's a time to be with your family. It's a time just to eat together and fellowship together, do things together. Let it be a time of, you know, let your downtime be prep time. And let it be a time of preparation where you can become a better person, a better family, a better leader, a better father, better mother, a better son or daughter, regardless of what's going on. But you're about ready to see something. Ursula, I'm seeing God connecting the pieces. We did a big puzzle yesterday and we lost two pieces. But God says, I'm gonna cause the pieces to the puzzle in your family. Something has tried to come to disassemble the family. But I'm here to tell you that nothing is hidden. Nothing can hide from the presence of God. And because of your faith walk, you're gonna begin to see that God is for you, not against you in this season. And though at times it's been a little scattery, God's gonna bring such a focus to that in this season, and you're gonna see God's hand intervene on behalf of your family. Jennifer Gunsterson from Toledo, Ohio, I'm telling you that you're about ready to see. I saw arrows, the arrows of the Lord coming not to you, but being launched for you, for your season and for your family. You're going to see that your faithfulness has prepared the way and has directed, come on, victory, and has even caused triumph. I hear the voice of triumph.
Yes.
I hear the voice of your intercession on behalf of your children and on behalf of your grandchildren in this last season, that God has heard your cry, and you're going to begin to see the manifestation of your heart's dream. Oh yes, sir. Yeah, you're giving. It's like the Cornelius prayer. The alms and the prayers of Cornelius came before the Lord as sweet nostrils. And so you're giving in this last season. Oh yes, and your worship and your prayers and intercessions have
yes.
gone before the living God, and you're going to see them manifest within your children and your children's children. Be a blessed, my sister, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen. Hey, Kristen, I just want to minister to you and to Ben and to your household. I really
yes.
saw the hand of God touching you guys in such an incredible way that God has not forgotten you. God has not overlooked you, but there is such a a ministry coming out of the things and the seasons you have been through, that right. God is elevating and causing expansion to come to so many areas of your guys' lives, both professionally and individually, just in your own development. And I even saw, I don't know if you have contemplated it, I don't know where it's been, but I almost saw like a book, like a memoir of the stuff you have been through, that right. God would take it and anoint it and cause, as so much healing has come to you over the last season, and through the tremendous things you have walked through and the tremendous tragedies you have endured, that God is going to give you a bounce back like never before that would be shared and with them, people to help them in their next season. And so I bless you and Ben and your household, and we love you and your beautiful babies. And I am believing that this is going to be the best season that you guys have ever seen.
Absolutely. Amen. Oh, goodness.
You guys enjoying this? I know this is a crazy night and a crazy season we're in, but man, I am so determined to keep our faith forward.
Absolutely.
And just to keep on pushing and keep on doing what we do.
Keep on pushing and praying. Absolutely. Marissa Jones, this is a great season for you and your husband and family.
Yes.
In Moses Lake. Yes, it'll be a season of increase for you. You're going to begin to see that God is the God of the open door. God is the God that is going to cause you to see what you could not see. The grace of God is going to cause favor to come upon your family in this next season, and you're going to begin to see it and partake of it and participate in it. I release that over you and your husband and your children in this season in Jesus' name. Michelle, Luna, I prophesy to you that it's your bounce back season. It's a season that the years come on, in the months and the weeks that the locusts have eaten and tried to destroy. God says, I'm going to give back to you all those things. I'm going to restore to you those things. I'm going to restore to you relationships. I'm going to restore to you lost finances and opportunities, for that's the God that we serve. It's a season where God is orchestrating everything out through the counsel of his will, and he has heard your heart cry. Oh, woman of God, your heart's cry has been heard by the Lord, and you will see the redemptive side of God, the God's right hand right now. Marianne Garcia, you're about ready to see that God is going to open doors for you to tell your testimony.
Yes.
God is, you've been faithful to tell it here and there, but God says, I'm going to cause there just to be a creativity within you, and a creativity and opportunities where God will give you the platform. And it's not just going to be in churches. It's going to be people want to hear of God's goodness come on over your life, and God is going to put you in situations and places and spaces where you never thought yourself would be. But God is going to put you in those places, and there's going to be grace that will be released through your lips, and people will come to the Lord simply with a testimony, because God has been that very good to you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hey, Danny, I saw that you just came on. Listen, we've just been sharing for a little bit, but I want to speak blessing over you and over your household. And I believe this is what I heard the Lord say, that this would be the greatest hour of redemption that you and your household has ever seen, that
yes.
God would take everything that has been against you in the last season and cause it now to work for you. What has been unbelievable, and the heartbreak and every tear that has been cried, that God would pour them out as seed upon your children and your children's children, and that you would see the goodness of God so turn things around, that which has concerned your heart as both a father and a grandpa, that God would work and mend and do what you could not make happen.
Come
He's going to make happen on your behalf.
Absolutely.
In this next season, and heal and redeem and soothe the places that have needed to be. Man, we love you guys. This has been fun tonight. We've been on here almost an hour.
I can't believe it. Did I ever tell you guys that I wrote a book? Come on, did I tell you I wrote a book? It's called Prophetic Journey. Maybe Meredith can hold this up a little bit, but it's Prophetic Journey. It's called The God of Our Tight Places is a subtitle, but it's been a powerful, awesome book. We've sold a ton of books already, and it hasn't even been 6 months now, but it's amazing how many books we've gone. I can't wait to get to Africa as soon as all this thing settles down and release that to Africa, and it's going to be written and interpreted in Spanish. So for my Mexican friends all over Mexico, Mexico City, Querétaro, Puebla, Monterrey, all them places. We're going to have books hopefully this year sometime that will be there. So I think it's been a good thing. Listen, if you haven't ordered a book, it's there. It'll encourage you. It's about 110 pages, so you can read it in a couple, 2-3 days or one full day if you're a fast reader. It's easy to read, and if you're a preacher, you should get it because there's a bunch of great sermons on there, I'm telling
you. And really, the book is very much equivalent to what we're going through now in the fact that all these storylines and all these different people who you talk about in here, from Hannah to Abraham, to Joseph, to all the different storylines that we kind of go through. It's a beautiful picture about how everybody's story was made in the midst of adversity.
Absolutely.
And how it takes adversity really to be, it's coming back to where we started with, that your faith has to be tried in order for it to be purified and to work. And so there is a trying of your faith.
Absolutely.
That is not punishment and it's not punitive, but it's the refining and the defining of it. So listen, you can order it. I'll put a link up here. If you go to Joey's Instagram page, there should be a link there that sends it to you. You could also get it on Amazon. We'd love for you to get it here so that we'll send it to you here in the next couple of days. But listen, we love you guys. And I am so believing that you would be encouraged tonight, that you would be strengthened, that your faith would be made stronger, and that
Absolutely.
You would not allow the spirit of this age and the fear that is wanting to shout at you to overwhelm you.
Right.
But that you would take the place and the faith that God has given you and you would walk this thing out. We get it. It is not an ideal season. We would much rather be at church tonight.
Absolutely.
Hugging and high-fiving and shouting and
Absolutely.
Worshiping together. But at the end of the day, God is still here, even in our dining room.
Even
with failed technology, with all of that we went through in the first few minutes.
Absolutely.
At the end of the day, God, there is no distance. And if nothing else, God's breaking our molds.
Absolutely.
I think we, as an American church, have got stuck a little bit in that we had to have the lighting right. We had to have the sound right. And we're spoiled people. And no shame to that. I love great worship and I love great lighting and I love all that those amenities to it. But at the end of the day, if you don't have a keyboard, if you don't have tracks, if you don't have a drummer, if you don't have anything and you don't have a good voice, you can still lift up your voice and God still shows up.
Absolutely. Listen, to those of you that are part of Cornerstone Church Tri-Cities, I this is our midweek service.
Don't forget to give.
That's all we're saying. We don't beg for nothing. We believe that you're taught the word of God here. And so there are ways to give. And you guys know all the ways to give. If you're watching for the first time and you want to release a one-time seed, go to our website. There's ways to give there.
I think Pastor Marlando actually added some onto this conversation too. So.
Awesome. So anyway, we just want to give you an opportunity to do that. The church does need people that are going to be generous in the season.
Especially in this season.
Forget the church. Don't forget the church or the churches. If you have a pastor
that
you
go to,
don't forget your church, man. We need people that are going to advance the kingdom, and it takes generous people like yourselves.
Absolutely.
I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope it was encouraging.
Listen, it's as easy tonight as texting to 84321. Text the amount to that number, 84321. And then from there, you can, it'll set it up, and you just want to go to Cornerstone Church Tri-Cities, find us, and then it walks you through that. But
Absolutely.
Listen, stay faithful, stay committed. We want God to stay faithful. That means we have to stay faithful.
Absolutely. I'm going to pray for you, Meredith, and I'm going to pray for all of you guys and there in social media land. Anyway, Heavenly Father, we thank you that we have the ability by your grace and your mercy, Father, to release, Father, words of wisdom, words of grace, and words that, Father, would be easily understood. And we just, Father, release your power, that you would keep your people, Father, from any kind of harm. We speak Psalms 91 over them, Lord. We speak, Father, that you are the great protector and sustainer and encourager. Quicken their mortal body. You said the same spirit that rose Jesus from the dead quickens our mortal body. I'm asking in this season, let the spirit of your grace come upon us to protect us and sustain them in our going ins and our staying ins and our going outs, Lord God, whatever it is. Yeah. We just ask that you just, Father, protect us Amen. In the midst of it all.
And for every essential worker, Father, that has to go back out to work tomorrow morning.
Absolutely.
For every healthcare worker, Father, we release blessing and we speak protection tonight, that you would keep them safe, that you would wrap them in your arms, Father. For every truck driver that's delivering toilet paper and other goods to people, Father, we bless them
Absolutely.
Tonight. And Father, we just ask that this would be such a season of safety, that you would cause your people to remain safe and to remain protected in the midst of all of it. And we all said amen. If you believe it, somebody say amen with
us. Amen. And we will see you on Sunday, and I'll be at the church preaching. And we promise it'll be online. So sorry for those of you guys who went online and all this.
Hey, and then one more thing before we get off here. If you guys are enjoying this and you like the feedback and you like to do some stuff, let us know also. And listen, there's times we can jump on during the week and just encourage you, take a thought, whatever.
Absolutely.
I know there's a lot of stuff out there on social media right now and definitely don't want to overwhelm people. But if you're enjoying it, just let us know, okay?
Well, God bless you, man. See you guys on Sunday. We love you, and we sure appreciate you guys tuning
Absolutely.
In.
Absolutely. God Til bless
next
you
time,
guys.
Hug two or three people in your family.
In your household.
Amen.
Bye.
Bye.